This could be the gateway to extraordinary things.
Trisha Bigger is our costume designer this year. She gets the graphic novel-esque feel of Da Vinci's Demons, and she elevates them to a whole different place.
We talked about the sort of overall visual feel of the show. They didn't want a sort of a historical documentary look, but a modern view of historical costumes.
You are not the first of your kind to arrive.
Our version of Leonardo is an explorer and adventurer without a whip and a fedora, but with longer hair and a different jacket. This season, we will be traveling to the New World. And the trip allows, you know, all of the characters to look like people who've been on a journey.
I am Ima Kama, and I shall answer all questions, but only to you.
Ima is a very powerful figure in the Inca Empire. She was a goddess. You know, you can't help feeling important, all dressed up in gold.
With the Incas, we did lots of research and worked very closely with an expert. There's obviously no written records of the Incan time, but there are some drawings from about 100 years after. We did try to be fairly authentic within the sort of spirit of the Incas.
The costume added to my performance, and I wouldn't change anything.
I knew right from the start that Alfonso was going to have two swords, so it took about 7 people to create the costume, and it had to be functional. We had to be able to draw the swords at any time, like a gunslinger, which is really exciting for me.
It was really amazing to see everyone in their costumes. Shapes are lovely, colours are lovely. You get a sense of who somebody is.
You must know you're mad.
It's the combination of different elements of Da Vinci's Demons that make it so exciting to watch.
It is one of the only shows that marries interesting elements of history with fantasy. We've smashed two worlds together in a way that is consistent and exciting.
Time to make history.